Hello everybody, welcome to another episode of the Gungeon. We've got some hunter stuff that we finished, so we're going to just check to see what we unlocked first. Turn your eyes upon the beholster. Bundle of wands unlocked. Excellent. Slay the terrible beast three times and return for a prayer. Okay, so we've got to kill the beholster three times. But in the meantime, we've just unlocked some wands. That's great. We spoke to that guy as well, didn't we? So we just continue on our ways. We've got 27 H credits. Let's buy that one. Gundromeda strain unlocked. Okay, that sounds pretty good. And it was quite pricey, so I expect it's going to do something pretty good for us. So we're going to go down to the first chamber. First run. Sorry if my voice sounds a bit funny. I've picked up a bit of a cold from my children, so you might get a bit of chest clearage on the way through this Gungeon play. So we've opted to go for the pilot today, just because it's been such a while, and we're going to just kind of, you know, we're slowly rotating through the characters, so that's kind of the plan. So we'll carry on with this guy and see whether he gets us any further than any of the other characters. We've been using the Marine for quite a while, so it's time to kind of mix it up and get that safety net of the armour out of the way. Because I think that's one of the main reasons we were using him, was just to get that extra hit in. But on the early floors now, I don't feel that we need the armour just to keep us going. So I'm pretty happy with just kind of cracking on. Oh, got a key up there. Nice and lucky. We've also got the lockpick with this guy as well, so we don't need to worry too much about some chests. If we run out of keys, we've got that. I think it's a 25% chance of opening the chest anyway. So we'll always try that if we've got no keys, and then we'll shoot the chest if all else fails. So plans for today. I don't know. We've got two keys already, so we could go for the secret floor, secret chamber. But I think we'll just see where this run takes us for now. If we get the opportunity to do so and it's easy and it's convenient, we did just destroy a water barrel there, then we'll go for it. But let's see if we find the other water barrel and see how easy it is to access and take down to the fireplace. But at the moment I'm thinking probably no. What have we got in the shield? So we've got some armor, we've got the night shield. I'm not a fan of the shield of the maiden actually, so I'm going to leave that at bay and just save the money up for something that we could potentially need later on. So we'll follow on down here. And it's looking like a fairly easy first chamber so far. It's nothing of note, all these, you know, little small rooms. Come through here. So we found our boss, but we don't want to fight our boss until we've got a better weapon. So we're going to look for our chests then. So we're not going to go for the secret floor. I think we're just going to play it straight and just try and get a win out of it, rather than spend all this extra time running through an extra floor where we could potentially lose, you know, more health than we need to. Let them kill themselves. So yeah, I think we'll just play it straight and see what happens. Hopefully, we've unlocked a few more weapons recently, so wonder if that will just kind of improve our chances, just having sort of more weapons in the item pool there to kind of pull from. This blue book is pissing me off. We've got another one somewhere? Up here. Hiding away. Keeping safe. Not for much longer. Does the pilot have? No. I thought the pilot had a second weapon, but it's just the convict and the hunter. Oh, we've got a nice chest drop. Now I'm going to check this one, because I think two runs ago from now, I opened a chest and it ended my run. What have we got? The fossilized gun. Ah, this, that one. The one. I think, yeah, there we go. Reload to set things on fire. And a gold chest as well. And I've not seen this one. Something to do with blanks. Blank companion's ring. He tries. It's just, oh, is that a blank companion? I've never seen that. So there's the things we unlocked, reloading, skulking, so we know what that does. Triggers a blank on active item use, okay. Raised in the Gungeon and bored of gunfire, he gets excited whenever an item is used. Okay, so that's going to be pretty much useless for us, because any time we use the active item, actually, if we use that in here, can we... Ah. We can't actually use it unless we're trying to open a chest. That's balls. Alright. He's quite cute though, isn't he? On we go. Let's go back up here. I don't think we needed to teleport that way, but we did it anyway. If we can get another active item, then I think that will come in handy. Well, we haven't got any arms to give him, so... Well, we've got arms. We're talking kind of metaphorically. Yeah, if we can get another active item that we can use regularly, then he'll come in quite handy, but for the time being, he's just going to follow me around with nothing better to do than just look cute. Get this big guy out of the way. This rogue legacy enemy wannabe. Where'll be at? Shoot up here real quick. I think through here we should have our final chest. We've got the fossilized gun. So we'll use that on the boss. Unless we get something better, then we'll use that one on the boss. But chances are we won't. Now, I've forgotten to change the transparency of my face cam here, so I can't actually see the map without going right into it. So I'm going to be jumping in and out of that map quite a lot, I think, on this run. Just because it's a pain to go. I don't like going into the menus whilst playing and just sort of messing around with settings. It just doesn't do it for me. Okay, so through here. There's our chest, another brown chest. And we've got the T-shirt cannon, which actually is very good. So, one more peep in the shop just to see. I don't think there's anything. I mean, the shield could be handy if we've got that now, but I don't really think we want to pay 38 for the shield. Don't think we need the armor. I think we'll just go straight to the boss. We'll use the fossilized gun and the T-shirt cannon. Start with the fossilized gun, set some fire, and then we'll just kind of carry on with T-shirt cannon. Oh, so he should hopefully set on fire now. Yep, probably. And the good thing about this is we can set fire all over the place and just keep him in constant damage whilst behind cover as well, which is really handy. So just kind of spray, remember to reload and get away. And as long as we stay away, keep him at bay, we should be doing alright. Where's he going to? So he is going up there. Oh! We almost took some damage from our own mishap there. He's going down slowly but surely. Oh, we almost got hit there. So just keep him in the fire. Keep dodging those bullets. He's going to come over here. No. He's trying to cut me off. I don't know what it is about the Gatling guy. Is he just going to land in the fire? Excellent, he's going to kill himself. No, he's not. One more hit. Ah, nice. The Gatling girl, I've just got this kind of block with. I can't seem to do very good against him. I mean, you know, we've got the master around, which is good, but, you know, unless we get a room with these here, I generally don't always get a flawless from. Is this a sticky? It is. Excellent. Down to the next floor. So we've got the guns we wanted, got some armour. I think everything's coming up pretty nicely so far. We've got a couple of guns. The crossbows I'm not generally a fan of, but the sticky one is quite good. You can stick a few enemies, just knock them all out at once. The fossilised gun I think I'll save exclusively for the bosses, just because I don't fancy setting myself on fire too much. T-shirt cannon I think will be our room clearer, because it's got a great knockback. It can just keep all the enemies at bay, and it keeps us, you know, reasonably safe as long as we're careful. I mean, for enemies like this, we can just go to our rogue special and just kind of chop away at them, because they're no threat really at all. And as I say that, I'm probably going to take some damage. No, good. I just can't seem to aim shit. Okay, so we've got some ghosts. They can have a bit of a t-shirt cannon. What happened there? We took damage from what? Oh, because I used my sticky crossbow without realising. Okay. So, right, we've still got 4 health, which for now is a pretty good amount. Switch back into our t-shirt cannon. So no secret room in here anyway, with the use of that armour blank. You stay up there. So we're just keeping these guys at bay. Walking into bullets. Just for the fun. Oh, come on. Playing like shit today. Where are we getting on? Where are we going? More enemies. I'll tell you what, let's just set those motherfuckers on fire. We've got a necromancer somewhere. He needs to die as quick as you like. But he's just going to run away instead. Come here. Lovely. So we're hoping to get the Beholster as well on the... Is he a third floor boss or a second floor boss? I'm not actually sure. Well, we've got the first floor, we've got the Twins, the Bullet King and the Gatling Girl. Second floor, you've got the Gorgon. Is it the Beholster? Because I know you've got the Treadnought on the third floor. I don't know. You'd think after kind of, you know, over 100 runs that I would remember by now, but it's just not happening. So we took way too much time in that room. We just let these guys murder themselves as they are quite happily prone to doing. And we kill those two guys. We'll follow through to the next room. So we're still looking for a different active item. Just to make this little blank effective. Because at the moment he's not really doing much, is he? And we need to keep away from those bullets. The only guys really that catch me out that bad. I know they're coming, but I can just never seem to stay away from them. Oh, there's another guy there. Hello. Right. Onwards and upwards, hopefully. But it doesn't look like it, actually. We're not doing very good. Although, I've had a few days off of Gungeon. We did some gameplay of Firewatch, and we started the park. Then realised that it wasn't actually that long, so we just kind of stuck it out and played the full game. And that should be uploaded as of today. Oh shit, I'm stuck on the wall there. Yeah, so we should have a full episode of that up there now. Well, a full playthrough of that. Which was not a bad game if you play it all in one sitting. If you try to, you know, start and stop, then I think you're just going to trail off the game and not bother with it, as I do with a lot of games that I'm not very impressed with. You know, the first three quarters, okay, you know, it's very story-driven, so the narrative is there. But the scare factor is not really there at all until you get into the last part. And that's when things ramp up very, very quickly. But then even so, there's more creep than scares. There's a couple of jump scares that will catch you out, but it's more creep. So, do we want to use a key? I know it's not a key anyway. So yeah, I mean, you know, if you play the whole thing in one sitting, it's actually a very good game. But where are we going? But yeah, like I say, if you don't, then I think you'll just trail off of it, and it will seem like quite a mediocre game. What else have we been playing, or are we going to play? The Spelunky we've picked up a couple of times, but I don't think anybody's interested in seeing Spelunky these days. I think it's run its course. So we may give up on that one. Unless anybody wants to see Spelunky, then leave a comment or let me know. And, you know, if people are going to watch it, I'll put it up. But if I'm just going to, you know, be streaming or putting it up on YouTube and nobody's watching it, it just seems like a waste of time. We could have quite easily put something else up, you know, some more Gungeon vids or something else that, you know, is going to be enjoyed more. And that's what I'm making the stuff for. I'm making it, you know, for the enjoyment of myself and you guys out there as well. Oh, we can only take one more hit. I didn't even realise until then. Maybe we do want to find our shop as quick as possible and see if we can find some health or hope for a health drop. I just realised we're using the starter pistol. We've got this t-shirt cannon and we're not even using it. I mean, we're saving on ammo, which is really good, but, oh, talking about ammo, what do we want to fill up? That's got plenty. Probably the t-shirt cannon, isn't it? Because we're going to be, hopefully, trying to remember to use that one from now on. I did say shop. I think we want to go over there. Well, we'll see where this takes us. Oh, look at that. We will open that. Plus one bullets. Plus one to bullet. What does that do? Give us an extra bullet. Masterwork bullets. Peer-reviewed studies have shown that these bullets are precisely one better than normal bullets. Alright, that's not very helpful, but thanks anyway. Plus one better than normal bullets. So what is our first bullet? More powerful than the others, maybe? I don't know. Ah, oh, fuck this. You son of a bitch. You son of a bitch. Alright, let's go for a quick restart and try not to play like absolute fucking dog balls. So, back into champion number one. And we'll try not to suicide. God, these loading times really get on my bloody nerves. Lovely. So back with the starter pistol, which we seem to use exclusively, even though we had plenty of good weapons to use. So we'll use this and try and pick up some better weapons, try and not to play like dog shit. I mean, we're, you know, a couple of videos ago we were consistently making it to the forge, so I don't know what's going on today. I think just a lack of play for the last couple of days has not helped at all. And probably tiredness is a factor as well. It's been a very busy day. It's my stepfather-in-law's birthday today, so on the old barbecue for that one. So we had a nice bit of chow over there. I actually built a new stand for my green screen behind me, because the one I was using was not really ideal. This one is kind of a lot better, so I've stuck my green screen to it, and it gives me more space behind me, so I can kind of get wider views. And I don't know if you've noticed, but the quality of my camera, as opposed to other videos, seems to be much better as well. I've got better lighting off it, so you know, I've got plenty of wood. I live just next to a place. It's a furniture place, and they build all sorts of custom-made furniture, bookshelves, kitchens, staircases, and they have a lot of wood just sort of sitting outside, which we can take if we need, which I do oblige quite a lot. I do a lot of DIY and build works. And yeah, I've built a new frame for the green screen. It's quite lightweight as well, so I can kind of move it around without having to pin things to the wall and having things in a static place. I can move things around quite easily, which for my situation for the streaming is quite handy, because I do it in my living room, and in the morning the kids come down, it needs to be kind of moved out of the way, otherwise it will just get torn down and destroyed, which I'd rather not have happen. Excuse me again. I think, as I mentioned before, I've got this horrible cold that I picked up from my kids, and it's coming on quite fierce, so I probably do sound very different to my normal self. But apart from that, you know, I mean, it's been a fairly busy day. I did have to run into work today as well. I got called in on last minute notice to cover for somebody, so DIY work, barbecue. Yeah, late night last night as well, so it all kind of catches up with you. Come on, you. Oh, hello. See you hiding back there. Did we open a chest on this run? No. No, we haven't. I thought for some reason that we had another gun, but we don't. We've only cleared a few rooms, haven't we? Yeah. Oh, get into the shop. We'll see what's going on in there. Sweet F all. We do have a water barrel if we decide to go for the secret floor. Probably not going there, though. So we just run across here. And, well, maybe we will if we can get another key, actually, because it's not too far away from where we need to be. I don't know. I'm gonna contemplate that one. because, like I say, I just want to get down to that forge. I want to deliver that television down there and be done with that, because that is taking absolutely forever. I want to get my first win, because I still haven't killed the bloody dragon. I want to do a lot of things with this game, but it's just not happening. I think it's down to my own lack of skill at the moment. But we get there. It's anything. It's like anything. It's like Isaac. You pick up Isaac and you think, fuck, what's going on? You know, you're never going to be able to clear that. It's too hard, too many enemies, too many floors. But the more you play it, the more you kind of figure out enemy patterns, and you know, you kind of, you pick up all the nuances about how the game works. And what is that? Antibody hills up. Sounds like a good thing. Chance to improve healing received, and experimental treatment administered by the Gungeon's medical unit. Okay, chance to improve healing received. So I guess we get a possible extra half a heart of health every time we get a half of health? Maybe, I don't know. But I'll take it. I'll take anything that wants to heal me, because healing in the game is one of the commodities that are not really around when you most need them. Usually when you get right down to those final floors and you realise, yes, I'm doing really well. Fuck, I've only got half a heart. And then you die like a fucking tramp. Is that a third chest? No? Second chest? Oh, I don't know. The head is just not ticking very well today. Oh, we used a key as well, so we're not going to the secret room. Okay, so that's been decided for us. Well, no, I decided without realising I decided. Oh, stay away. I mean, we're getting to the point where this first floor is more just in the way than anything. And there's the key, so we'll buy that. Won't bother with the armour. I don't think we quite need the armour at the moment. Where are we going? Where are we going? Yeah, just across here. Get these motherfucking tables out of the way. We'll open the brown chest for unfinished gun and another key. So, essentially just free key, or free gun rather. So we will use the unfinished gun against the boss, which is not the best to be honest, but it's all we got, so we can't complain. We've got the Gatling goal again, fantastic. Accuracy of this gun is balls, so I expect maybe we'll just use very special. Now the best thing, I think, is to just keep him in the corners of the room if possible. Just kind of dodge the bullets nice and slow, nice and easy. By the time those bullets get to you, they're nice and spread out for you to just kind of walk through. And then you take a hit as you're trying to look like you know what you're talking about. Over there and try not to do the same thing. Where's he going? Come around here, please. Thank you. No, you're going to teleport instead. Okay. You do that then. No. I think my own impatience is getting to me at the moment. I just want to get this first floor out of the way, done and dusted with. But it's not really doing me any favours. So maybe we'll just slow up and play a bit more careful. Use our blanks. One thing we always forget to do, use our blanks when we need to. If we think we're going to get hit, hit those buttons. They regen every floor anyway, so I don't know what the fucking hell, what the problem is. There we go, he's dead. Oh man, what's going on tonight? Is that the M1? Oh no, the Winchester. Okay. Oh, and another key. Okay, maybe we are going to the secret floor, because we need the extra guns just to keep us alive for a bit longer, because we're playing like shit. Do you want to buy that half a heart? I think we should probably buy that just to make sure we don't die too early. Oh. There we go. Is that going to go straight beeline for the door? No, we're going to have to contend with this bloody table, aren't we? Yeah, oh, just as well. Oh no. Oh, come on, are you serious? There we go. Oh, please don't do this. I can't even get the barrel through the door. How am I going to get down to the forge? Is that door directly in line? Or is it slightly offset? Find out in a minute. I'm flipping these tables out of the way. Oh, look at that. That's perfect. Hold. Water barrel. Lovely. So it's not very often you actually get to open up both chests on a floor and still go to the secret floor. I think that's the only reason really why I'm doing it, because it's just quite a rare occurrence to be able to do both. And my biggest issue for getting through to the end of this game is ammo. We get right down, have just the, you know, well hardly any ammo left. Do we want to risk our luck? No, we don't want to think like that. Risking the lockpick is a bad idea. Ammo. So, you know, the more guns we can pick up and the more money we can pick up, potentially means good. We've also got that extra heals. Is that, did we get that on this run, or was that the last one? I can't even remember now. I'm going to have to have a quick check in the Aminomicon right now. We still have it. So, yeah, we've got the extra heals, which is a potential lifesaver. We'll use the rogue special to begin with, and kind of see if we want to switch out, we'll switch out. Now we don't have any keys now for the floor, so I'm going to rely on either key drops, key in the shop, or the lockpick. What happened there? I blinked. I blinked. Oh shit. Guy with the pretentious glasses first. There we go. Oh, what the fuck do you think you're doing, boy? I think you deserve a bit of Winchester. There we go. Ah, the gun doesn't even reach that far. Let's just do a bit of that just to save our lives a bit. Down. Oh, bad idea. Let's go back. Play at a distance. It's our safest play, I think. Just about reached that guy with this weapon. And he can't hit us because he is shooting in all kinds of directions. Well, just like us, actually. Lovely. And we got a full heart of health from that. So, all it has been fixed in the world. We poisoned that son of a bitch. But we have also cornered ourselves. There we go. That's the door. No, there is no door. Is there a secret? No, let's not bother trying to look for it at the moment. There's another room there. Can't open it. We'll hold off for now, just in case we do manage to get some keys. As long as we stay in line, we should be fine. Oh, shit. We're going to move to the next platform, otherwise we will take more damage. Oh, man. There we go. Through to another room that could kill us. Get that way. Excellent. So we'll be fighting the Blob, you lord, Blobulon, Blobulator, I don't know what his name is, Blob King, fatty fatty boom boom, as a boss on this one. We can't actually get a flawless on this boss either, because it just doesn't let us, but we have a chance at extra items, which is what we're going down here for. So, we've also got the crest up there as well, but I will take it, but I won't go down to the Abbey of the True Gun, because I've already been down there. I've defeated the Lead King, and it was absolute bullshit. It was just a pointless battle. You know, you unlock some stuff, which is fair, but there's no real reason to go back there once you've been there once. Not in my eyes anyway. I don't think you gain anything for it. If not, you know, a couple of guns, but I think it's more hassle than it's actually worth to go down there. You've got a higher chance of fucking everything up and dying. Whereas this floor is always a bit debatable. Sometimes you can get away with it, sometimes you can't. At the moment, it looks like we can't. Maybe I'll take that crest now, because if that will save us in the short game, it could well end up saving us in the long game as well. So we'll take that, and I know you guys are probably looking, thinking, what the fuck are you doing? But I don't care. I'm not going to bother using it for anything, so if anything, it's just a glorified piece of armour, which hopefully will save the day. Let's go out, got another blank. Got blanks all round today. What have we got? That guy, I think, deserves a Winchester, so I don't fancy getting cornered in. Oh, put a grenade as well, just to throw us off guard. There's our shop. Excellent. Keys, and half a heart. We'll have to come back once we've got another bullet for that. I think we need the health more than anything. Nope. I had a hunch, but it didn't pan out the way I wanted it to. Oh. And of course, when we need a... Shit. For fuck's sake. We should have bought the key instead. Just as I've lost my fellow thought, we're gonna die. Again. Holy shit. This is not going well tonight. Let's crack on, one more. And this is all because we've switched from the marine, I think. Not that there's much of a difference between the characters. They're the movement, the way they shoot and everything is all the same. It's the colour of the bullets. It's throwing me off. Go through again. And we get one of these purple guys straight off the bat. What the fuck? Come on. Give me a break. There we go. Okay. One room down. About a million left to go. Open it. Extra health will definitely come in handy. Definitely. We could do have a gun for the next chest, which means we could do have a key, which means we're asking a bit too much for the game. Because that just doesn't generally happen, does it? There we go. Just dodge roll into death. Excellent. To the next room. Two of them, come on. The game is just laughing at me now. It's just saying, here we go. You're gonna have a bad play today. And we're not gonna help you out one bit. Come on, you. Die so we can carry on dying somewhere else. Nice. We can actually afford... I was going to say we can actually afford the key, but we're on a different run again because we died, didn't we? there we are. You dead? Yeah, you dead. You better be dead. Let's get the big blue guy out of the way first. Try not to get hit by that. Okay. We're doing slightly better than we have been doing. But I don't want to speak too soon, because every time I do, the opposite happens. Right, got lots of money coming to us. That's always a good sign. I think, is it the more money you get, the better you've done in a room, essentially? I think that's how it works. If you take damage from enemies, they give you less money or no money at all. But I could be lying. Circle strafe this guy. Yeah, he doesn't stand much of a chance because he's too fucking slow. teleport there. We'll get these guys. So we're going to probably get some more spawn after this as well, so stay in a safe spot. I thought we had grenades coming, actually. Threw me off a little bit. Now, there always seems to be cheese, or bits of cheese on the table. And since when the fuck do bullets eat cheese? Somebody tell me, what is that? Proximity mine, clear cornerstone, I can't remember what that one does. But we've got loads of keys. Is it worth buying these keys up early, do you think? I think it probably is. Because they're a rare commodity, like I said before. Definitely worth buying those up. So we'll go back to the for the third one. Once we've got enough, what are they, 21, I think, so we've got 9, so 12 more to go. Lovely. And we still haven't found that chest, have we? No, we haven't found that chest yet. The game's mocking us. I think it's just trying to tell us that today's not going to be the day. We've got a chest in here. Yes, we do. Is it Mimic? Nope. Open it up. We've got the genie lamp. Magic lamp. Sorry. We've got to hit the enemies 3 times with this to get the full effect of it, which can be a bit of a pain. So we'll save that for some of the bigger guys. Almost fell right into the water there. So do we buy the key to get in there? I don't know. We'll see. It looks like our chest is going to be just up here. We'll see what happens with this chest and if we get a key drop. Oh no, there's no chest in here. We were wrong. We were fooled. It looked like the room was just the right size to have treasure in there. But again, I shouldn't be so silly to just assume that. Let's come over here and check it out. Where are we going? Up and up. More traversing, and that's our boss. So we must have already. Oh, we did already open a chest anyway, didn't we? And we can't. We can't afford the key. So let's go for the boss and see what happens. This is probably a good time to test out this. Which, it seems alright. Does the job. We just keep shooting and avoiding. It seems to be taking his health away, so as long as we're careful, dodging. Ah, for fuck's sake, just as every time I say it. As long as we're careful dodging, we will stay alive anyway. I don't think we're going to get killed now. He's going to lose his health pretty quickly. We'll just walk away, and by the time the bullets get there, he'll be dead. So, excellent. Luckily, we already picked up a health upgrade off this floor. We also got the fossilized gun and some health. Fossilized gun, okay gun for bosses. We can actually get blank and half a heart if we go down there. But I don't think we really want to waste a key on a blank and half a heart, do we? So we're going to ignore that. Actually, we can afford that key. So we'll pick up that key. It's probably a bad way to go, but it's a green chest, so if you get hit, land the ground and die. Oh, thanks, mate. That's awfully nice of you. Great old pep talk there. If you get hit, lay on the ground and die. Always keeps me alive. Open him up. Open him up. What's that? The void shotgun. Okay, yeah, we can take that. That will do us quite nicely. We just pick up a blank. We might as well use it, actually, for the secret room. I've got a feeling it's there. But it could also be up here. Maybe we'll try it in this room. Wrong decision. Doesn't matter, though. We've got another 2 on the next floor, so we'll just go through. I do keep forgetting that we have a lockpick as well. Hang on. Lovely. Okay, so we've got full health, extra health upgrade, we've got a couple of guns, and we're on to the second chamber. So things are going well for tonight. Let's get this loading time out of the way, and we'll be well on our way to a winning run. We'll see. Alright, so we're going to take the television with us. We're going to use our starter pistol, I think. Starter pistol and the void shotgun. Oh, actually, if we're going to one-shot with this, then I think we'll roll with this. We'll clear the rooms out pretty quickly with this. If we can hit the correct enemies, they'll probably take an extra shot. As they do, yep. This room can actually drop the H-coins. I've got a screenshot somewhere where we dropped one around here from an enemy, which was quite interesting. I think it's just an extremely rare occurrence. Ah, this is better. So any ammo will go towards this gun. We'll keep this gun alive, and it should keep us alive in turn. Hopefully even against this guy. Yeah, lovely. Spent bullets, that's what I like to see. Reload. Now we want to try to avoid strafing with the purple, the purple guys, because the second we start to strafe, they start to try and kind of figure out where we're going to be, and then they get us. So what we got in the shop? What is that? Bionic leg. I've never seen that, so I think we'll try and save up for that. So that's 46. We can pick up 46, then we'll come back and we'll buy that. If we can't, then we simply won't. And remember to reload. Three shots, are you serious, mate? These guys take two. Ooh, dodge roll. Nice. Lovely. That's how room clearance should happen. But it doesn't always work out that way. Come on, you. Ooh, gold one. Well, we've got enough money. It's just that one enemy as well. That was nice. That was a nice bit of luck. Oh, we couldn't quite get both those guys in one hit. Oh, that guy. Oh, no. It's alright. We're good. Have we got health laying around somewhere? Yes, we have. So we don't need to worry too much. Oh, there's another room down here. Let's go down this way. Maybe we should just actually go buy that bionic leg now. I'm guessing it gives us speed increase. More machine than man. We felt a little bit faster running then. Movement speed increased, yeah. Okay. Yeah, I mean, it feels a bit faster, which is nice. If we can outrun a bullet that we couldn't, or we usually wouldn't have been able to, then I think we'll be happy with that. But we still haven't had our ammo drop. Do we get frequent ammo drops when our ammo's running low, or is that just something that doesn't happen? We should have reloaded for this room. Uh-oh. Where's the other guy? There you are. Get to you before you get to me! Lovely. I've got a chest coming up. Nope, we've got a room that wants to kill us coming up instead. So we've got 64 bullets left. I mean, this holds a fair amount, for its power, a fair amount of ammo is held in here. We haven't got a key for that one. Let's open up the shortcut real quick. That is the... Oh, I thought I had the crest for a second then. That is that room, so we will come up here. So hopefully we'll get a key drop. If not, got the lockpick, which I've... Oh my god, that came out of nowhere. Relentless. I'll have to use a blank for that. See, I don't get it. They don't trigger the trapdoors, but we do. Doesn't set me as very fair. Oh, now they're just appearing out of nowhere. That's taking the piss, isn't it? Right. What do we have? The door number 742. More of those ghosts. Oh, and more getting stuck against walls. And wasting ammo. And fucking hell, what's going on? Oh, no, 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 no. Come on. Ugh, I can't even set that on fire. There we go. Is that it? Is he the last guy? Alright. There's another one. Let's see how well this does. Is that a one hit? Oh, that's a one hit. That's alright. Happy with that. Damn. Be another chest. I think we'll lockpick this one. Ah, no. Wasn't worth it. But it was worth it for the health anyway. If not anything else. So we'll come down here, get our other piece of health. Buy a key, if there was one in the shop. I don't actually remember if there was one in the shop. But if there was, then we will buy it. If there's not, then we use the lockpick, which you actually know we can't, because it's all been spent, hasn't it? There was a key. Let's buy some ammo. No, well, it needs to be. It needs to reload. Okay. Open this one up. Yeah, I will take it. I will take it all the way. Except for I can't. Oh, I can't I? Because we've got yes, brilliant. So we want. I think maybe the magic lamp and void shotgun is the way to go. Beholster. We actually do need to kill this guy anyway. So we've got the one blank, so we need to try and save that for the best possible time. Oh, reload. We do have the movement increase, so as long as we're careful. Needs one more magic lamp attack. Oh, no, we don't want to do that, do we? Alright, we're getting a bit overwhelmed here, and we are empty. Uh-oh. Alright, we took some damage, but we're still going to live, I think, through this. Not if we're using this bloody void pistol, we're not, are we? Magic lamp is what I meant to select. Oh, we can actually knock the missiles away with the magic lamp as well, which is handy to know. Oh. Okay. Uppercut to the face. Lose all our health. Do we get a good gun? We get some ammo. What do we want to use that on? The void shotgun. I thought we just bought some ammo for the void shotgun, or did I just select the wrong gun accidentally? And the blooper. Okay, so we're rolling with some pretty good shotguns. We are going to... I completely forgot we had the invisibility as well. Fucking brain, will you wake up? There we go. Get the television and keep the stuffed star, I think is what we want to do. Now, do we still drop it? We still drop it every time. Great. Okay. So we don't want the lockpick anymore because it is a piece of shit. We can't afford anything in the shop. Oh. Dodge rolling is going to be an issue again. We didn't buy the ammo, did we? Because we couldn't afford it, which is why we don't have it. Okay. I remember. So, two more kills for the Beholster, and we'll have our challenge completed. Which seems fairly easy, because it's not, you know, an impossible boss to beat. I mean, you do have to make it down to the second chamber boss, which today we did struggle with. But, let's not talk about that. Wait for the loading times to get through, and we'll continue. Black Powder Mine, Chamber 3. We're going to stick with this as a room clearer. Or is the blooper more effective? Should we have a look? Do we get a key and ammo? Let's fill out a magic lamp. So, shotgun, blooper. So we'll test out the blooper for now. That also does wonders for us. But it has knockback, so we'll save that, because that one is actually... Oh, this ammo. 127, 84, 88. Slightly better for that one. Not that we actually really need it. So you can one cut ride. We're never going to get this TV to where we need to get it, are we? It's just never going to happen. So for this room, I think we should have a go on the blooper. Actually, maybe not. I think maybe we will switch out between them, because once we've shot a few shots, the other gun reloads. So we use one clip from one clip from the other, and that should actually, is that going to eradicate our... I want to just drop it temporarily. Eradicate our... Fuck me! I'm trying to say, eradicate our reload times. Which I think will actually be the case. We'll find out when we switch over to the next gun. Yep, leaves this gun fully reloaded for us. Which is actually quite a nice little... Fuck me in the ass. We're gonna die again. Down to poor play. Right. But we've learned something new, which is really good, is the fact that if we're running with two shotguns, we don't need to reload, because we just use one clip, switch, use another clip, switch. Which is definitely... Oh, I did actually use a blank right on the time that I got hit. But that was just absolute bollocks today, wasn't it? So... thank you for watching, guys. That was episode 27 of Enter the Gungeon. If you like this video, don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. I'll leave my Twitch in the description down below. You can check that one out. But thank you for watching, guys, and bye-bye.